Previously on Godiva's.
He's a show off. He's probably got a little one.
Dating a dancer, sometimes I gotta accept that we want to dance with someone else.
We owe $260,000 in taxes.
You're gonna clean it up for us, put it through your books, cut us a check.
But if we launder money, we could go to jail.
This doesn't feel right.
Maybe you shouldn't be here at all.
Sam, I'll do what you want.
Any cash deposit over $10,000 and the watchdogs want to know about it, make sure there's no fraud or anything.
This here's my partner, Detective Longoria. We'd like to ask you a few questions.
I don't know what to do with food anymore. It's not speaking to me.
It's not normal for son not to like his mother cooking.
Ramir's local food kick, all concept, no vision.
Good review is like curse.
Ramir can't take the pressure.
He's not even trying. Thinks he's got nothing to prove now.
Heads up, Marty. I'm gonna spice things up around here.
What, you bringing your mother in?
Yeah.
Hello, boys.
She's gonna pick up the slack till we find a replacement for Daisy.
And bring a touch of India to your kitchen.
Well, Ramir doesn't cook Indian.
Oh, shows what you know. My son made a delicious tikka just yesterday.
Wait, dude, we're going Indian now?
We're adding some influences. A new spice palette. And it's not up for discussion.
God, this.
Yeah, sounds yummy.
Oh, Victor, delivery's up.
Not the warmest welcome.
Wait till they see what you can do.
What can I do, Ramir? I don't know anything about restaurants, and they don't want me here.
Well, I do, and I'm the chef.
Let's get you in.
The first kitchens weren't just where you cooked your food. They were the center of a house, the source of heat and light. It was where you were surrounded by family, warmth, comfort. Then came the revolution.
Right.
Servants, appliances, and gadgets flooded in. Suddenly, your kitchen was just functional, walled off. The hearth disappeared. This kitchen you called your own, it's gone cold.
Ramir?
Do you know anything about math?
Yep. One part sour apple plus one part vodka plus one part lime juice makes a great apple martini.
Simone, it's that cop.
He's a cop?
Back room right now. He's probably got some sort of a warrant and he's gonna bust me here. Right in front of a packed house. That's great.
Not wearing his best Armani knockoff.
Go and greet the man.
Hi. Detective Longoria?
Hi. You got a table?
Oh, for you and your partner?
Oh, just me.
Oh. Great. Right this way.
That's good.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah.
See?
Yeah,
you
see?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, I did.
Slide me some skin.
Slide some skin, Marty. Watch your back.
DJ Tyrone. Heard you're kicking it hard, spinning some good shit.
Yeah, tell your little yappy dog to quit sweating us. We want in.
Why? So you can step out of the place? Throw me a few punches like last time?
We want to dance, baby. What? Afraid to show us what we got?
Let him in.
So they burn their bridge and you build them a new one?
Yeah.
Okay, Preeti knows how to blend her spices. I just wish she knew how to shut up about it.
If she wasn't Ramirez's mom, I'd have locked her in the cooler. She helped make food taste better.
Look at you. You go, girl. Let's see some moves.
No, I can't dance alone. Stay?
Yes, cheek to cheek. Genital to genital.
Victor! Woo, salty language.
Nah, you should see her and her new partner, Emil. It's quite a show.
Come by tonight, Cordell. Lots of Latino men. Eye candy.
Oh my God, this pie.
It's so good.
Gained a pound just looking at it.
No, it's incredible.
Daisy, make this pie.
No, she didn't.
Buy from Sam. Who else make pie like this? Ginger and apple. Berry.
Touch of hazelnut butter on top.
Yeah, little pastry flowers on the crust.
Just like Daisy always made.
I miss her.
Kitchen's not the same without her.
She's more happy with Sam.
Yeah.
In the Dark Ages, you'd have been an invisible servant, confined to a hot, smoky kitchen, hidden from your master's dinner guests. The only real appreciation you could hope for would come from your fellow workers. Camaraderie was all you would have had to get you through the hell of your day.
Yeah. Hello. I'm Preeti Kapoor, Ramir's mother.
Oh, mother.
Thank you. Yes, I had him very young. Did you enjoy your meal?
I had the garam masala crusted salmon. Loved it.
Oh, no, wasn't up to snuff. Next time, Ramir, we must use less cumin. Overpowered the cardamom.
I thought you were the chef.
I am. She's just sitting in.
Tomorrow, I will show you how to make the perfect garam masala. You know, I think I'll have a glass of wine.
Okay, well, good luck with your lessons, Ramir. Thank you for a lovely meal, Miss Kapoor.
You are more than welcome.
Tell your friends.
Definitely.
And bye, Ramir.
Don't look so glum.
She was a hussy.
You want to be like your friend Martin over there? Always jumping from girl to girl? No. You are devoted to your craft. First thing tomorrow then. Yes? Good boy.
My mom just blew my action for the night. How's yours coming?
Fine.
Try this. You slide your fingers in her hair, and then you tell her you really want to kiss her neck, but you know that once you start, you won't be able to stop.
I know. I've heard you use it a few times now.
Well, it works. Just give me your pointers.
Yeah, well, I'm doing fine on my own.
Ready?
She's okay.
You date her?
For like half a second, she's history.
Man, this gig is tight.
Yeah, thanks.
With the right promotion, it could be huge.
Adrian gets the word out okay.
Yeah, sure. You want to DJ professionally, you gotta have the right exposure. Why don't you grab me a Red Bull, hon? Older crowd, bigger venue. You know, my dad knows one of the owners down at Network Records.
Network?
It's time to think big, Tyrone.
Promotion. Why now?
Except I will never be doctor in Canada. Now I need new path. I need something to learn.
Well, it ain't cooking in my kitchen, Victor.
Ramir, he's just putting together cold plates and desserts.
Look, it's nothing personal. But you get in the weeds, you'll drown us all.
I'm surgeon in China. I precision hand. You say I'm not smart to cut cake?
There's 100 culinary school grads out there frothing at the mouth for Daisy's job. We can do better. It's that simple.
You trained on the line.
You can shape me how you like. I'm like dough in your hand.
Yeah, I get it. Okay, we'll try a few nights, all right? All right, this is a fucking amateur hour here.
Sorry, am I interrupting?
Hi.
No, we're just leaving.
Everything good with dinner?
Oh, it was great. I could tell you about it over a drink.
Look, Detective, you have more questions. I'd rather do it here.
Oh, I'm not on duty.
Okay, well, how can I help you?
Say yes to a date sometime.
Oh, boy. Well, it's just that I'm... Okay.
Incredible, they're so sensual.
So I'm sitting there savoring every bite of this pie, and it was like a fork in the heart knowing Daisy made it.
Okay, so you had a good pie, now watch a good show.
I'm watching.
Why did I snitch on Daisy?
Because she was stealing.
For her brainwashing boyfriend.
Hey, I've heard of the conservatory. Sam can't be that bad.
You haven't met him. Stick, tell Drew.
You sure as hell don't trust him.
We have to get her away from him.
Yep.
He's taking her spirit.
He's grabbing her ass.
Where's he going?
Oh, no.
Hands off. Touch her again and I'll kick your ass.
Dick, stop it.
Son of a bitch was feeling you up. Hey, asshole, you want to screw her? Why don't you wait till I leave the room?
Oh, my God, those are the moves.
I saw the way you were looking at her. You telling me that's part of the dance, too?
My only interest is to create a passionate dance. Clearly, that's working. Relax. My true partner's right here.
That's him, your mom.
My wife, Lucia. Cuidado, tío. It's one mi casa.
You're a real piece of work.
At home, we always used to drink hot chocolate this way. Of course, I made a few adjustments. Shot of vanilla, bit of cinnamon.
Smells amazing.
It's an aphrodisiac chocolate. Now, apparently Casanova, he used to eat it before he, you know. Yeah, I gave him stamina on the Aztecs. Cuckoo for their cocoa beans. Oh, God. When I get nervous, talk about food. Such an idiot.
I think it's sweet.
You do?
Sure. Very original.
Sorry if I cut in during your dance, but...
Cut in? Stick, you picked a fight with my partner.
Look, the guy's a sleazeball, okay? He was trying to grope you through your clothes.
Hello! It's supposed to be hot. That's why they call it salsa. God, I'm happy. Isn't that what you want?
Yeah, I just thought I'd be in the picture.
Well, you make it kind of difficult. I mean, look, our first competition's tomorrow. I don't think that you should come.
To see how a person lives, you just have to look at their kitchen. A seasoned cast iron frying pan says they cook a lot and well. Single plate, dry in the dish rack, they eat alone. But a couple of wine glasses left on the counter and you know someone was entertaining. And for some reason, there was no time to clean up.
Hi, Jane, friend of Martin's.
Ramir, roommate.
Towel.
Thanks. So Marty up?
Yeah. All night.
Oh, I meant up awake. I didn't hear a thing, honest.
I'm surprised.
Good morning.
Hey.
You make good coffee.
As good as your chocolate?
I don't know. You're gonna have to give me another taste.
Wow. I may
need lots if you want to come.
I think I'll have that shower.
After last night, I finally know what all the fuss is about. That's my boy.
You must learn a few things from the old man here.
Figured you'd take credit for this.
No, I'm just proud of you, that's all.
Everything good in my life, you try and take it. You can't have this one, Vermeer. This one's mine. It has nothing to do with you, so back the fuck off. Damn it, Mac.
Hi. Hello, welcome to the conservatory. Ava, would you like to make our new guests comfortable?
Sure. Yeah, of course. Come on in.
Hello, Daisy. Savitri.
Conversing with you no longer serves my purpose.
Look, I'm sorry about getting you fired.
That's your guilt, Cordell. I can't fix it.
He misses you.
So does everyone.
Well, I don't miss them.
How about we just go for a coffee? Talk.
I don't need to explain to you why I am happier as a healer. Cordell, I am more than just a pastry chef.
Well, you are never just a pastry chef to us. We love you because you're funny and caring and bake amazing pies. Daisy loved life. I mean, do you even laugh anymore?
Sam?
He's the last thing you need.
You're trespassing. Get out.
Where's the love, Sam?
Savitri made her choice. If you could respect that, maybe you'd still have a friend.
If you weren't feeding off the vulnerable like some disgusting parasite, maybe she could think for herself.
You little faggot.
What did you just call him?
Get the hell out of here.
Sam?
Careful, Sam. Your mask is slipping.
Come on, Cordell.
Daisy, I beg you.
Our session's starting, Cordell. It's time to leave.
Charged her with shoplifting, then cooked her up a dinner.
The turkey.
With all the trimmings.
Well, well. Little Katie Bloom. It's good to see you. It's been a while.
Howard. Hello.
How are things?
Restaurant's doing well.
Money's still flowing. That's good.
Mm-hmm. Probably won't be long before, you know, boom time just kind of runs its course.
You better bank it while you can.
Oh, way ahead of you. Playing it safe.
Good girl. I'll be sure to stop by.
How do you know that guy?
Oh, I don't. I mean, I do, but I don't. He's, used to be a regular.
Nasty piece of work.
Oh, you know him?
Oh, yeah. Vice Squad's keeping an eye on him.
This whole Hinto India thing's more popular than a eunuch at a sing-along.
Oh, two more fish and a baby cowboys.
You have to keep calling it that.
But I have dessert for you.
I can't serve that. It's one of Daisy's cult pies.
Yo, we're a little busy here.
You should have seen her. She's an empty shell. Pie without filling.
This pie have ice cream and melt. Move.
Cordell, Daisy's gone, and we're getting dangerously close to weeds here. She needs our help. So do I. Can you score me your friend's van tomorrow?
Move a few plates and we'll see.
Ay, not so much, Dominic. You don't want your fish to look jaundiced?
Fine, I'll start over.
Premier, don't cut that eggplant so thin. These aren't brownies in your sister's Easy Bake Oven.
Easy Bake Oven?
Mom, please. Is it like the one with the little light bulb?
Yes. We got one for Chandra when she was 7, but Ramir took it over straight away.
Wait, if Chandra was 7, that would make you like, what, 12?
Ramir was a sensitive boy.
Hey, proves I was made to be a chef.
I don't know, Ramir. Those brownies were awful. Tasted like wet chalk.
It was a mix. I bet you look so cute. Hey, did he serve them to you on that tray?
Yes. And he would wear white gloves. And he had such good presentation. So professional.
Presentation? What happened?
Thanks. Thanks a lot.
So I could get us into the college scene, book some sweet gigs.
Make people follow us.
If you don't move on, they will. Private meeting.
We're just working out a few things.
Well, you can work out the things with me, too.
TJ, that won't fly. Not if I gotta check with your boyfriend all the time.
TJ and Adrian are a team.
TJ's an artist.
He needs a real manager, not this homo chipmunk here.
Whoa, chill, Coulter.
I just call it as I see it.
Adrian, we'll talk about it later.
Way later.
You asshole. You wouldn't have even started spinning if it wasn't for me. Adrian, I'm not
Wait for it, you wuss. You and TJ have something great. Coulter just wants a piece.
Back to the res, Pocahontas.
Don't you ever talk to her like that again.
Big man all of a sudden.
Yeah. You know what, Coulter? These are my friends. You're not. You need to go. Now.
Coulter. Let's blow. TJ?
Oh. My hero.
Wow. Think you might want to work up an appetite?
I'm pretty hungry already. Glasses?
Yeah, over there.
Okay. Enough.
Of you? Not possible.
Seriously, I thought this was a date, not just some necessary prerequisite for sex.
Why not skip to dessert?
Because I kind of thought you were boyfriend material.
I am.
Well, then don't act like your roommate.
I am not like Ramir. I'll be back. I've got a couple candles in my room.
Be up in 6 hours.
Sorry, it's the downside of working in a restaurant. Late nights.
Serves me right for just dropping by. How about dinner at my place tomorrow? I'll make a mean parmigiana.
Dinners don't really work for me. I'm always here. Always.
Don't you get a night off?
Yeah, but I try to save those nights for me. Alone.
Well, we don't have to do anything. Just chill, watch a DVD.
No, I can't start this with you, Brett.
Thought it was going pretty good. That's what the signs were telling me.
Most people make chai wrong. You add the tea when the water's cold, then boil it under 30 seconds or the tea will be bitter.
Was that a car door?
Relax, Ramir. Papa's at a movie with Chandra. This chai is a reward for such a successful night.
I'm doing great, Mom.
Yes, but now you're in my kitchen, so strain that tea. Move!
I tell you, the things they put into these midnight shows.
Papa, it wasn't so bad.
There's no way I'm sitting beside my daughter watching that. Wait till your mother hears about what you've been watching. Pretty shit. What the hell is he doing here?
We're having chai.
Great. Things are finally getting normal around here.
I was just leaving.
Not before we all sit down, have a cup, and fix this mess.
There's nothing to fix. You brought shame to this family.
He is also your son.
Don't you defy me! Is that what you've been doing? Spending your nights out with this louse?
Yes, I've been doing what I bloody well want.
Papa, I only came by for a recipe.
That's not true.
Mom,
a recipe? What kind of man shares cooking tips with his mother?
A better man than would cut up his son to fit the mold of his own pompous dreams.
Grow up, both of you! I can't take this anymore. We're supposed to be a family. How can you hate someone so much? In your own blood?
Just tell me, if Sam's so great, why aren't you defending him?
Words can't hurt him. Guys, I want to go home.
This tending your garden crap is just a way of tuning
Cordell,
out.
Cordell, will you just stop it with the judgment?
Cordell. Savitri, you see your subconscious as a garden. And when you hit bad thoughts or memories, they appear as weeds.
They are weeds. It's that simple.
What were your weeds, Daisy?
I'm not doing this anymore.
What the hell has happened to you?
Victor, take me home.
Give us a minute.
Victor, please, just take
Daisy,
me home.
Daisy, there's your weed.
Oh, my God, is that guy's blood?
This is the place where your trouble began. You sit here with dead man.
No, I pulled these parts out of me. They don't touch me anymore.
Daisy, he is in your garden. He is the weed that killed all good things.
Sam made me clean again. He took the blood from my hands.
You only close your eye to horror.
God, you closed your eyes too.
I hold on to what made me strong. Sam, he made you weak.
You know, enough. I want out of this van. Open the door.
Where's the peace Sam give you now? He give you nothing.
Just open the door, please.
That's for you to do. Open your door.
Take me back to Sam! Take me back.
Here. Not really dressed for guests.
Sorry, forgot to call.
There was no drinking, I promise.
Oh, I feel so much better. Tell me you used protection.
No, Simone.
Are you trying to make every single one of my mistakes?
We didn't have sex.
Yet. Just working your way through the family, are you?
What? Did you guys...
Simone, please.
No, we did not. Now get dressed.
Why? You don't want me with you.
Not when you keep breaking the rules.
Name one rule I've broken.
The biggest. Don't turn into me.
Simone, if you could just see how good things
are... What the hell do you know? Last time you were in love, look what happened. Now get into your clothes, Chantel.
Sorry if I was a little overeager last night. See, getting physical with someone is, new.
Could have fooled me.
Guess I got a few tips from Ramirez.
How new are we talking here?
Really new?
Why does this keep happening to me?
What's wrong?
I'm, like, virgin bait.
Take it as a compliment. You're so sweet, safe.
Yeah, great. Heard it before.
Believe me, I'm an eager student.
very proud, Kate. You gave Godiva's its renaissance.
And you know how I'd like to be thanked by getting your buddy Howard off my ass?
Pardon?
Come back.
Well, it's not possible. You're in charge.
Don't you care that I am laundering money through your restaurant?
Enough. I can't hear this.
No, well, you're bloody well going to.
There's nothing I can do, Kate. Stop looking for a hero. If you want one, be one.
You know that TJ's running a club out of the loft now?
My son's a survivor. It pains me sometimes to know that he's at his best without me.
Godiva, I'm gonna take you off speakerphone now.
My son and I have the best of relationships. And why is that, Kate? Because we don't try to control one another. TJ knows that no matter where I am, he's always in my path.
Godiva?
I was down the hall, I heard her voice, so.
You think she'll ever come back?
Won't be for any of us.
So what's it like having a mother...
who doesn't care?
Yeah.
You figure if your own mother thinks so little of you, you pretty much expect the worst from everyone else. And that's why when you find someone you can trust, you don't let them go.
Flip a switch and you have heat. Turn a tap, you have water. But not too long ago, just making food would consume your whole day. The kitchen wasn't some canvas for creativity. It was for survival.
Miss Ramir, I thought I would be the first one in.
Didn't think I'd see you here today.
Let me worry about your father. You need to worry about our spice lamb.
Mom, you're a vegetarian.
I will cook what people want to eat. It's not my business to judge.
You're sacrificing your beliefs.
For a relationship with my son. That's more important.
And your relationship with Papa? He'd freak if he saw you here.
Well, he won't, Ramir. Thanks to you, I'm doing what I want. Now, the lamb.
Brief Encounter is still the most romantic movie ever. You know, when she's listening to his train in the distance. It's my favorite part. Just gives me goosebumps.
My favorite part is watching you get them. I'd really like to kiss your neck right now, but I'm afraid once I start, I won't be able to stop.
Now that's romantic.
Wanna go to my room?
No, let's sit here for a while. You are ready to go all the time.
No, no, we can do something else. Ice cream?
Look, I've done this before. I'm like your training screw.
Jane, I can't help it. I really like you.
Yeah, for a few more weeks. And then your eye'll wander and you won't be able to help that either. When you start having sex, it's like you start puberty all over again. I'm not up for dating a 17-year-old. To winning.
Well, third place anyways.
The first time competing and we brought home hardware. I'm smiling.
Yeah, keep practicing.
Next time we'll leap over second, bring home the blue ribbon.
I just feel so alive thanks to you.
No, baby. It was you.
You made it happen.
You saw what you wanted. You didn't let anything hold you back.
I knew there was passion in you.
I just needed someone to unlock it.
Shall we?
She has no right telling me what to do.
Look, if you don't follow the rules, it's back to your grandparents. Are you sure you want this?
Pour it. I don't care. I'm not going anywhere.
No, you can't stay with me. I mean, it's the first place she'll look.
You've got the perfect deal. The loft, the restaurant, no mom telling you how to live.
Yeah, sounds great. I think the party's gonna be over if you book out of here, though.
That's sweet, but you'll be fine.
No, you think you'll go?
I don't know. Seattle, that's supposed to be cool.
Yeah, a great music scene.
I miss hearing you spin. Next time I see you, it'll probably be on a CD cover.
Doubt it. Not if I stay here, I'll get stale.
Thinking of moving your gig to a new venue?
Yeah, need better exposure. Look, Seattle might be a good place to make a mark, get noticed.
For real?
Yeah, Colter's probably right. Need to take my show on the road.
Seattle's got plenty of coffee shops to work in.
Tax-free, American Green.
We can totally hitch down there.
Are you serious?
Oh, my God, I think we are.
How do I fire my mother?
Ooh. Normally, I would say keep it on my side of the desk. Don't make it personal and do it on a Monday. But Canning family wasn't taught in business school, so.
Because a smart man would never hire them in the first place.
She knows she's on the bubble?
Hell no, she's having the time of her life with us.
No. Well, you might hate having a cookie on the line that changed your diapers, but everybody else likes her.
Kate, if she keeps cooking with me, our marriage will fall apart.
Your father?
Yeah.
What a twerp.
Yeah, try arrogant, controlling asshole.
Apple didn't fall far from the tree.
They had an arranged marriage. This woman matched them up.
Wild.
Mom said it was rough at first, but somehow they fell in love.
Well, that's a precious thing. You don't want to be the one that wrecks it.
Speaking of love, heard you went out with the cop. News travels.
Well, it's not going anywhere.
Why not? Afraid you'll find out about your sordid past?
Actually, yeah.
Hey, go for it, Kate. I mean, the lowlifes you're stuck working with, you won't do much better.
No, I guess I can't do it.
Hey, you don't have to do anything. You're a beautiful woman. You're a catch. Just let yourself get cut.
My advice? Look your mother in the eye and tell her the truth. Women appreciate that.
Okay, then I'll try that.
Working hard?
One piece of San Homho salad. Then I lose new job.
Hey, here. Figured you're moving up in the world. You could use it.
Chef hat?
It was my mom's when she worked here. Said when she opened this place, his hat was her good luck charm. So, you know.
You cannot give this to me.
You've done a lot for me, Victor. You didn't have to. I won't forget it.
I have no what.
Well, tell Adrian I'm off tonight. You can thank me for the tips later.
Where the hell were you yesterday?
Out with friends. Didn't you get my message?
I called everyone. No one seemed to have a clue where you were.
It wasn't anyone from the conservatory.
Why do you keep seeing those people?
It's not like I had a good time.
Then stay away from them. Stopping deliveries to Godiva's.
Sam, I'm not going to stop baking my pies.
You said it yourself. You're a healer now.
Yeah, but Sam, don't you think the food that I make, maybe it helps people too?
No, I don't. And I can't believe how fucking arrogant you can be.
Sam, why are you...
You gonna start with the waterworks now? You are just a big gaping wound of need, and I keep having to mend it.
I can take care of myself.
You're pathetic, Savitri. You're a naive child.
Sam, that's my coat. I need it.
No, what you need is a long, long meditation, and we'll see if that realigns you. See you in a few hours.
Sam...
Am I that terrible?
No, Mom.
Well, then why would you throw your own mother out of your kitchen?
Because I know how bad it'll get if you keep cooking with me.
This isn't Raj, India. I can have a job and a husband.
Not this job.
You're not backing down from your father, and neither am I.
All right, but maybe I don't want you there. It's kind of weird, you know?
Working at Godiva's, I see what a gift you have. I'm proud of you.
I come by the restaurant anytime.
And you come back here. This is your home too, Ramir?
Sorry, Mom, but it's not.
Well, damn it, it's mine. And I will host whomever the hell I want.
Mom, language.
Yes. You boys are a terrible influence.
Thanks for seeing me. You wanna sit down?
No, you sit. I've been doing some thinking.
Yeah, well, I've been doing some other things. Listen, last night, Emile and I...
I heard.
You did?
Yeah, third place. I think that's wicked, and I should have been there supporting you instead of acting like a jealous idiot. Just can't believe this amazing...
Listen to me.
No, I... Like, I know that you're gonna meet men every day who want you, but you're here with me. Yeah. I promise I'll always trust you.
Okay, then.
Hey, run in. It's all too much. It's all too much. Oh, thank you.
I thought you lived here a while.
Yeah, I'm just starting to home it up.
What's this?
Oh,
a plaque from high school. What's a mathlete? Oh. Sorry. Detective. Habit.
Look, I can tell you now, no matter what, there are things that you'll never know about me. Ever.
Trying to scare me off?
Yeah, you bet I am. Yeah.
All right, then. I'll wait.
Excuse me. Hello. Hey, Simone.
Every time you go to a house party, you end up in the kitchen, standing around the bowl of ripple chips. You can talk to anyone about anything. The kitchen's still the fire we gather around to tell our stories.
How are you gonna do the duck?
Put in a five spice with a jackfruit and juniper berry stuffing. Ask Jane to come by, see what she thinks.
Jane broke up with me.
Oh, man. That sucks.
Turns out you and I are more alike than I want to admit.
Mr. Sherman Tan crushed your heart?
No. I liked her too much. And too often. Sex helped get me sane.
But it also made you crazy. Believe me, I know. There's more where she came from, Marty. We'll hit a club after work. Pride's playing wingman.
Couldn't handle the competition.
Aw, come on, that cute little face of yours? Women will be lining up to sit on it. Hello?
She could be anywhere.
Brett's called the downtown station and police put out a call. They're gonna find her, Simone.
My parents did the same thing when I ran away. They never found me. She's turning out exactly the same.
Then there's nothing to worry about. You landed on your feet, she will too.
I checked for TJ. He's gone also. He lived with your daughter.
Oh my God.
That little shit.
Hey, we don't know. Maybe he's out there trying to find her.
No. Today he tried to tell me he leave. I can see now.
But you knew he was taking her and you didn't do anything?
I did not understand. You think I'm not trying to stop him if I know?
It's not his fault, Simone.
God, I'm such an idiot. I should have just sent her back when she showed up. Now I've made it worse.
Hey, you did all that you could, Simone. You know that.
It's my fault.
Daisy. Oh my God, look at you.
Girl, what happened to your shoes?
Are you all right?
I wonder, would you have a job for me?
Yes, we have a place for you here.
Thank you for not giving up.
You see, Sam, people come back. Hello?
Sir, hello.
You guys open?
You bet we are.
Good. Table for two?
Cordell?
Of course.
Let's do it.
You're in for a great evening.
Are we ready, Ramirez?
I'm beside you.
And lock us in a cannery with your accordion.
Most people don't cook in their own kitchens anymore. You just use it to plate up takeout or rinse the wine glasses. You make a room of sterile steel and cold granite. Fancy, modern, and dead. The hearth, the place you're meant to gather, has left the kitchen. But it hasn't left our lives. It couldn't. Because no matter what, we need to be warmed, fed. So we find new places to eat, new ways to gather, new families to form.